Hello my dear friends, welcome back again in the new video of Power Learning channel. So in today's video, the video is very important for all the generator technicians and electrical technicians. So kindly don't miss any part of this video. Watch complete video so you will learn something new. Let's get started.
Two types of wiring connection of three phase alternator. Okay, this wiring diagram is for Stamford alternator. Okay, and we have two types of wiring connection with 12 wire connection. So here if you see, this is written 12 wire connections. Okay, and today we will discuss about these two. One is series star, the another one is parallel star. Okay, so how the windings are connected and why we are doing these changes in our alternator, we will know in this video. Okay, so in this configuration, you see it's written series star. Okay, so series star means that each winding is connected in series end to end with each other. Okay, all these, this symbol is for winding. This symbol is showing the winding coil, our winding coil, which is located inside our stator. Okay, so we have one coil, two coil, three, four, five and six. With six coil, each coil having two ends. Okay, this is starting end and this is ending end. Okay, so this coil having two ends, this coil having two ends, so total we have 1 2 3 4 5 6, so 6 multiplied by 2, total 12 leads. So that's why we are saying this is 12 wire connection. Okay, similarly here if you can see, this is parallel star. Okay, the same wiring, the same alternator, but now it's connected in parallel. Each winding connection is connected to each other in parallel, while you see here they are connected in series. Okay, so what is coil actually looks like? If you see, normally we see in the motors we have one copper wire and which we make winding like this, and we will take like this. Okay, so this is starting end, this is closing end. Okay, this is the last end from the winding side. Okay, similarly here we have total 12, so this symbol is showing to this coil, this is winding coil. Okay, so each winding coil having its numbering. Okay, like U1, U2, U5, U6, V6, V5, V2, V1, W6, W5, W2 and W1. Okay, and the main three output is here. This is our red phase. Okay, which is mentioned U here. You will connect your red phase power cable here, yellow phase power cable here, and W phase and the blue phase will be here. And neutral, if you can see, this is your star point. Neutral you will connect here. So total 4 wires you will connect for your output, and it will go to your main circuit breaker of the generator. Okay, similarly if you see here parallel star, so it is also more easy to understand. Here we have one coil which is having two ends, U1, U2 and the U5, U6, so all these two coils making one phase of the generator. Now if you see, the two starting ends are connected together, and the ends, two other ends, two other sides of the winding are connected together. Okay, so if you will see it like this, okay, this is one phase, this is another phase, second phase, and this is our third phase. Okay, so all three phases, the two ends of their winding, we make it now on neutral. So they are now connected with each other in parallel. Each phase winding is connected with each other in parallel. Okay, and the ends of all these six coil are connected here, while here these are connected in series, so the resistance will be more. When two coils are connected in series, the resistance will increase, while here resistance will be decrease. Okay, in this the resistance will be decreased because both of them, they are in parallel. Okay, so normally in standard configuration we are using series star three phase four wire system to producing 380 volt line to line and 220 volt line to neutral. While when we are using low voltage parallel star, so in this configuration we select 127 line to neutral and 220 volt line to line. So once you need to convert your alternator from 380 volt 220 to three phase system 220 volt, so you have to use parallel star. Okay, parallel star for producing 220 127, series star producing 380, starting from 380, and you can maximum rating is 480. You can increase line to line voltage 480 volts. Okay, here 220 and 127. Okay, here how you will connect your AVR. Now we will see the AVR wiring connection. So here you see we have three sensing wire for the AVR, 8, 6, 7 and 8. Okay, if you are using three phase AVR, so you have to use these three wires 6, 7, 8 to your AVR. Okay, but if you are using single phase sensing AVR, so you have to use only these two wires 7 and 8. Okay, so similarly you will connect with the power cable these two control cable of the AVR, okay, in your alternator, and here it will be changed. It will be took from here or W on the main terminal. The sensing wire will be on the main terminal, also on the main terminal if you are using three phase. If you are using single phase, three phase 220 system, so you will take it two wires only, one is 8 and one is 7. Okay, so if you have any question, any confusion, you can ask me now. I will further explain to you. In physical, I can explain you here how it is in physical. Now you see in our terminal box we have one plate like this, which is having terminals here and here and here and here and here and here. Also I will extend this here and here. Okay, so we have here terminal, and in this terminal normally there is no connection. Okay, normally there is no connection.
Okay,
so this phase is, this is our U1 and U2.
Okay
for red. So here we will took our red phase to the breaker. Okay, from here we will take our yellow phase wire, here we will take our blue phase, and here we will took our neutral wire. As per our current, we will increase number of wires. Maybe our amperage rating is more. Maybe you will find here two cables, sometime four cables. If the cable size is reduced, then number of cables will be increased. Okay. Now we will see the internal winding of this. Okay. For internal wiring, how we will connect, because now we have to connect one wiring in series. So U1 will be here because it is showing on the load side.
Okay.
Then we have V1 on the another terminal. So we will write here V1. Okay. U1, V1, and here the third one is W1. So we will take W1. Okay. So now we connect our three leads for output like this. Okay. After this, what we will do, we will connect U2 with U5. Okay, so these two windings are connect, will be connect here like this. This is coming from inside alternator. Okay, these are coming from inside the alternator. Okay, so here we will connect our U2 and U5. Okay, you will see U2 and U5 will be here. Okay, so now you see the difference here, how it's look like and here how it look like.
Okay,
but we know the, now you have you will understand how it is connecting. See, U1, the other side of the this winding is U2. So U2 will come here. This is the same winding but rotating from inside the alternator and come here. Then from here we connect with U5. Okay, and the other part of U5 is U6. Okay, so U6 is connected on our neutral, so we will bring one U6 here on neutral. Okay, so now you see
this.
Yes, now see, this is our I show you the winding. Now the winding is like this. This is our one coil. one end is U1,
okay,
and this side is U2. Tamam? Mm. The other winding is U5 and U6.
Okay.
So this winding also inside the alternator, okay, like this winding. These are windings. Okay. So we connect this terminal U5, okay, here. Mm. Because they are coming out like this.
Okay.
Okay. We connect this part here and the other part of the winding we connected here.
Inside.
Inside. This is our, these are coming from the alternator.
Okay.
So this another part we connected from inside. So how it is connected now? See, U1 is connected with U2. Okay. Mm. So these are two coils, but U2 is connected with U5. So we take this wire from here to here. So now you see it is connected in series. U1, the end of the U2, okay, is this coil is going to U5.
Okay.
So they are connected in series.
Series.
And the end point going on neutral.
Okay.
You get my point?
Yes, yes. Like is.
Yes. Like you see, U1, U2.
Yes.
And U2 is connected with U5.
Mm-hmm.
But it's actual like this. Okay. Because if we will make like this two coils. Okay, this is first coil, this is second coil. Okay, so this is our U1, this is U2, this is U5, and this is U6.
Okay.
Now I connected like this. So if you take it this here, so it, this will be in series.
Mm-hmm.
But now only we connect like this. Okay, and this point going to neutral. Okay, if you see here, U1, U1. U2, U2, and here U5, okay, U5, because they are showing here single point.
Mm.
That's why don't be confused, okay. Actually, these are four terminals. These are four terminals. First, second, third, fourth. So total four terminals, but they merge here. Mm. They are showing here one point.
This figure.
Mm-mm.
And parallel, not
same. No. These is series. See,
okay,
end
series.
To end.
Okay.
End to end. Even this is series. See, it's starting from here, going here, then going here, then going here, then I'm going out from here.
Mm.
But in parallel, how we will connect,
okay.
The same I will make now parallel. See, we make like this, one coil out, okay. Now parallel means here.
Yeah.
So I will make it parallel, okay. Then I connect these two together and these two together.
Mm.
So now they are parallel to each other.
Okay,
you got my point.
Yes, yes.
See, the same, but only they change here V like this. Okay. Mm. But I make it straight.
Okay.
So here, what, this is our U1. Okay. This is U2. This is U5 and this is U6.
Mm.
So now we will make on second page full three winding, so to understand, okay, what you want, series or parallel?
Parallel.
So for parallel, we will make it like this, one coil, okay, with two ends.
Mm.
U1 and what is another end? U2. So here we have U2. So there is many ways you can draw it from your mind. Okay.
Okay,
now we will draw the second coil. Okay, this is second coil, and what is the number? U5, U6. So we will write here U5, U6. Okay,
mm.
If now we want to connect this in parallel, we will connect these two together and these two together, as you see here, U1 with U5, U2 with U6.
Okay.
And this terminal will go to neutral. Okay. So now I will show you how I will connect. I will take it this to this, and this is our output, okay, red phase.
Okay.
And this is our last end, which is going to neutral. So now you will see this is only first phase.
Mm.
Similarly, we have other two phases. So now I will make draw for the other two phases. Okay. And okay, and here we have our Okay. So now you see, we will connect it like this again. Connect here. Okay. Connect here and connect here. This is our yellow. This is our blue. And all the neutral is here at one point.
Okay.
So now you will compare here U1, U2. Okay. U5, U6. Okay. Same. But now we change the design. See here how they connect. Okay. And now here we connect. Yeah, yeah. But both are correct.
Physical like this,
if you see from the windings, okay, is it like this? Okay. So if you understand simple way, so you understand what is going on from inside and outside, but inside they are only windings and they are two ends. So now we'll complete this. This is our V1, V5. So here we have V1, V5, W1, W5. Okay. And what we have here, we have another part of V6 and V6, V5, V1, V1, V5, V6, V2. Okay. So this is our V6. Okay. V6 and this is our V2 because this is V1. So the other part V2, same like here, U1, yes. U2, U5, U6.
Yes,
so W1, W2. Okay, W5, W6. So now these three phases are each other parallel. And here this is in series. So there is many ways to make it series. See, end to end.
Okay.
Here we connect, not end to end, two windings in parallel. Here in series.
Okay.
So you got the point?
Yeah.
And what voltage you find out, you see, with this configuration, this is parallel star, you will get 220/127. This is line to line, this is line to neutral.
Okay. Can you draw the neutral phase?
Yeah, this is neutral.
Okay.
This is neutral. Four wires going to the breaker. Now these are four wires.
Three wires from here and three wires.
No, three wires, these three wires. These three are one common wire. See,
okay.
They are connected at one common point.
Yes. Right.
Okay. It is showing here common.
Yes, yes.
So you will take it from here.
Yes, yes. Okay.
So guys, I hope you like this video and you learned something new today from Power Learning Channel. So if you like this video, kindly share it with your friends. And if you have any question, you can write me in the comment box. Inshallah, I will try to give you all of your answers. And still, if there is any confusion, you can let me know so I can explain further. Or if you have any comment regarding any other subject videos, okay, you can comment me also so I can make a video in order to explain you in a simple way, okay, as per my experience. And inshallah, we'll see you in the next video. Till that, take care. Have a nice day. Assalamu alaikum.